questions? Anyone at all?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Congressman Austin Scott was here a couple of weeks ago, and I asked him a question. He addressed health care while he was here. How would you feel about removing the age requirement on Medicare so that people who wanted to join Medicare and pay into that as a younger person, maybe not 65 but 55, would be able to?
That's an interesting concept, one that I don't know that I've ever really thought about that much. But certainly something we need to consider. Obviously, we're going to have to consider some kind of a long-term stability for our Medicare program. There's no question about it. You know, folks, right now we are $18 to $19 trillion in debt. And I've always said that the only way we're ever going to be able to address that debt is, first of all, we're going to have to cut spending. Secondly, we're going to have entitlement reform. And thirdly, and perhaps most importantly, we're going to have to grow our way out of it. We've got to have economic development so that we can grow our way out of that. That's why this Highway Trust Fund, that's why transportation funding is so vitally important. Because you can't have economic development unless you have infrastructure, unless you have transportation, good transportation. So we've got to do that. This is certainly something that we could consider and that I will take back to Washington with me and that we will consider. A unique concept indeed, so thank you for that.
Thank you.
Are we doing anything
Good question, thank you for that. Because that was number two on my list. We got to have entitlement reform, which, you know, if you look at our budget right now, you take out all the discretionary funding and just leave the mandatory spending that's in it. Take out all the discretionary spending that's in our budget right now. You still can't balance our budget. You still can't. Obviously, we've got to do something about entitlement reform. I mentioned earlier the sustainable growth rate, the Medicare fix that we have for physicians. We have some entitlement reform in that. Not a whole lot, but look, it's a step in the right direction. So we've already started in that direction of trying to have entitlement reform. It's never going to happen unless we wake up in this country and make it happen, because it's got to happen in order for us to get back on solid financial footing. Jeff?
Do you believe talking heads about this CARE Act, telling us that the rates are going up 20-30%? So what are you going to be able to do about that?
Right. Well, first of all, we being the majority party in the House of Representatives, the Republican Party, were deeply disappointed at the ruling of the Supreme Court of King versus Burwell. Quite honestly, we thought it was going to go the other way. We thought it was pretty obvious the way the Supreme Court had ruled. Well, obviously, that didn't work out. Obviously, they made the wrong decision, which, you know, say what you will about the Supreme Court, but it was, in my opinion, it was the wrong decision. Just got it wrong. So does that mean that we give up now? Does that mean that we are not trying to replace and rebuild Obamacare? No, it does not mean that at all. We still continue to do that. Let's face it, it's going to be, it will take a new administration for that to happen. The president is simply not going to let this happen. This is his signature. This is signature legislation, his legacy. He's not going to, he will veto that. We won't have enough votes to override that veto. But we continue to work on a replacement for that. In fact, I served on the subcommittee of the Republican Study Committee, helped subcommittee come up with an alternative plan. A plan that takes into consideration the free market, puts the free market back into health care. It gives us competition in health care. You know, I'm an independent healthcare provider. And it's not just independent pharmacists, it's independent healthcare providers, independent physicians, independent pharmacists, independent physical therapists, whatever, that are being pushed out of the market now because of Obamacare, because of the increasing rates. It is not an affordable CARE Act. It is an unaffordable CARE Act. Prices keep going up. We see that. The rates keep going up, and you see what's happening in the insurance world now. All of a sudden, we have a consolidation of the healthcare plan with Cigna and Aetna. And all of a sudden, before you know it, we'll have only two or three healthcare plans out there to choose from. And folks, when you take competition out of this scenario, that's not good. So we're committed to continuing try to replace this with something that will be market-driven, something that will give consumers choices, choices as to who they want to use in their health, as their health care providers. Well, again, let me thank you for having me here today. It's an honor to serve the 1st Congressional District. Let me encourage you again. We all need to be pulling together with Moody. This is going to be very important. We appreciate your support. You know, I've met a number of people who've been stationed at Moody over the years. And to the person, they continue to tell me what great community support they have down here. I mean, when you talk to someone, even the chief of staff of the Air Force right now, who was stationed down here at Moody, the first thing he told me, yeah, I was down at Moody. What a great community. Even left my family down there so my kids could finish high school down there. I mean, it's just amazing. So let me thank you for that. Let me congratulate you for that. That is something that all of us should be proud of. Again, I want to ask you for your prayers on this Iran nuclear deal. This is very, very serious. One last thing before I leave. I have to tell you a story. I'm trying to decide whether there are more males than females here. Okay, I'm going to just have to tell it about the males, so y'all have to be upset with me for a little while. But anyway, my wife has finally decided that she's going to retire, although she's having withdrawal pains. She actually worked yesterday. She has cut back. And I heard a story the other day about a gentleman who retired. And his wife was very concerned about him. She actually went to the doctor and said, "Doctor, you got to do something. My husband's walking around the house all day long just talking to himself." The doctor said, "Wow, that's bizarre." He said, "You mean to tell me he just goes around the house talking to himself all day long?" She said, Yeah, he just goes around the house talking to himself. He said, "Well, does he realize he's doing that?" The wife looked at him and said, "No, he thinks I'm listening to him." So anyway. Thank y'all very much. Appreciate it.